In this video, we're going to go through the process of opening up and processing a RAW file in Camera Raw 9.1. The first step is to neutralize it or use your white balance tool, which is over in the third from the left. There's our white balance tool in the toolbar. I'm going to zoom in. Normally, I would have you shoot a color checker or a gray card, something that we know to be neutral. Because we didn't do that in that case, I'm going to take a look at the image, and I have the side of the knife. I also have this specular highlight, both of which should be neutral. So I'm going to click in there. You'll see over on the right sidebar that white balance has now changed from as shot to custom, and I'm going to zoom out. The next thing I'm going to do is actually take readings of the image. I'm going to click on the color sample tool. I like to go from pure, the darkest point to the lightest point, so I'm going to take in a sample. You can see the readings. Remember that 1 or 0 is pure black, 255 is pure white. I'm going to take it on a transition. The next one is at a transition between the highlights and shadows. I'm going to place a third in the front. I'm going to place a fourth over here in the fruit. So that's 4 in the shadow areas. I'm now going to go to the midtones. And you get 8 altogether. My last one is going to be on a highlight area. And let's see, here we go. First, you want to evaluate all those numbers. And I can see that my brightest ones are still at kind of a medium tone. So that means because I want both my shadows and my highlights to be brighter, I'm going to move the exposure up. I'm keeping an eye on those. In this case, because it's a fairly moody image, I'm not going to bring the highlight area much higher than about 220. Now my shadow areas are still pretty low, so I'm going to go down to shadows. Moving that to the right, I can see those numbers start to increase. You'll notice that it looks brighter on the screen than it's going to print. So down here, I now have some detail on number 4. It's still pretty dark, but that is a shadow. If I want to move it, I can just press and drag. So here's kind of a little more open shadow. And overall, that looks pretty good. Next, I'm going to go into lens corrections. This is an older image, and the camera raw does not contain its lens profiles, but you can, yours will. So you can click on it and unclick to see if it's making the kind of changes you need. I'm going to go into profile, remove chromatic aberration. Those would be the specular edges of specular highlights. So I'm going to zoom in and I'm not really seeing any fringing. So if I did, which would be kind of a purple line along this highlight, I'm going to zoom out. Use manual. And this is where if it wasn't shot straight, if I had some distortion, this is where I would change it. I'm going back to the basic. If there's an area that I would like to be darker, one of the tools that we have 3 tools where we can do specific areas. One is the gradient, press and drag, and here's my exposure. You'll notice the panel has kind of changed. If I had very specific areas, I could do it with the brush. But at this point, I'm happy with how it's looking. Now at the bottom, I'm going to click on the workflow line. I'm going to go with ProPhoto, which is the largest color space. I'm starting with 8-bit. If I had very smooth gradations in the background, I might do 16-bit, but it doubles the file size, and I don't want to do that. I'm not going to resize. I'm going with the default size. The resolution is 300. You can do some sharpening if you know whether you're going to be working in matte or glossy. I would keep it at low. Say OK, and at this point, if I want to get out of the specialized gradient options, just click on one of the other tools. It takes me back to the basic panels. At this point, I would then click Open Image. It's going to take a little bit and open up in Photoshop. And I would then save, and my recommendation is that you save it as a TIFF.